Hello friends, here we will solve an example of macro call within macro definition. For detailed explanation of this macro parameters, different data structure, algorithm, please watch my previous videos. Here we will solve this example. So this is our source code and we are going to convert this source code into target code. Means we are removing definition, macro definition as well as macro call. Now here you can see in this program there are two macros or three macros, I think so. So first is this macro whose name is INCR, macro INCR, this is my first macro. Second macro is DECR, here is the definition of this macro, so this is second macro, okay. And third macro is OPER, okay, third macro. This OPER having this INCR and DECR as a macro call, means this OPER is having two macro call, macro definition inside macro call, okay. So this macro call inside macro definition, this, so this is my third macro. So we will see how to convert this source program into target program, means how to remove this definition as well as macro call. Okay, so this is MDT. MDT is MDT number and card. This is the data structure of MDT. MNT, macro number, macro name and the MDTC position of this MDT table. Okay, so we'll convert. We'll start with, we will scan line by line the source code. So first macro. So in macro, definition table, we are not going to write this macro keyword. But amend we are going to write, because of this amend we will understand, yes, this is a macro which is ended over here. Okay, so we'll start with first macro INCR. So initially my MDTC is 01, macro name is INCR and percent ARG. This is a argument which is a formal parameter. Okay, formal parameter. So we'll write the macro name is INCR, MDTC is 01, so we'll write information in MNT table. Okay, so next line, load 1 and percent ARG. So for this and percent ARG, we are going to put this information into ALA. So ALA will have 01 and percent ARG as a parameter. So this is a ALA for INCR. Okay. This is a ALA for INCR. So we'll write this one. INCR 01. Now next instruction 02, load 1 and ARG 1. Whose position is 01 in ALA? So we'll write instead of this ampersand ARG 1. Hash 1. Why? Because we are going to replace this formal parameter with the actual parameter. So we are going to give hash 1 here, number of this ALA position. Now next, increment your MDTC, add 1 hash 1. Okay, then finally amend. So we are going to write this amend keyword here. Okay, now next macro. Every macro is started with this keyword macro, okay, and macro name is sometime there is a label, macro name and the parameters, okay, formal parameters. So next, at which position we are going to store this macro? At fifth position. The macro name is DECR and now. So we'll store this information in MN2 02. Macro name is DECR, position of MDTC is 05. So we'll create ALA for this. 01 and percent num is a formal parameter. Okay, now next is load, incremented load 2 and percent num. So here we'll write hash 1. Why hash 1? This hash 1 is of this DECR, not of this INCR, because currently we are in this macro. So hash 1. Incremented 7 sub 2 f1, then 8 store 2 and percent num is nothing but hash 1. At 9 amend. So here is amend of the macro. So we are going to write this M and L cell. Now again one macro is there, macro, okay, 10 position will store in MDT. So macro whose name is OPER, macro name is OPER, and percent ARG1 and percent ARG2. So we'll store this information in MNT. Macro name is OPER, okay, and position of MDT is 10. So ALA will have two parameters, okay, 0102 and percent ARG1 and percent ARG2. Okay, now next after this INCR we have to write INCR and percent ARG1, and percent ARG1 is having position #1 in ALA of OPER. This is a OPER ALA. 12 DECR #2, then 13 increment MDTC add #1X, and finally 14 M end. Okay, so in this way we have done this macro also. So we got this MDT, MNT, and these are the ALA. Now we will see our source program. Now our source program start with this, means after a scanning line by line we reach to this start statement. So here for this program only we are getting our target code or the final output. Okay, so start 200, so we'll write this start 200 as it is. So this is not having any macro call, so we'll write as it is. Now next is OPER AREG BREG. This is a macro call, OPER AREG BREG. So AREG and BREG, these are the actual variable. So OPER is present at which position? 10th position in my macro table, macro definition table. So 10th position. Now here one more data structure is required, means MDT, MNT, ALA, and one more data structure is called stack. Why is it so? Because here we have these two macro calls, INCR and DECR, which are inside the macro OPER. So whenever we are calling this INCR, we have to come back to next line after execution INCR. So we are going to store this information into stack. So this is a stack organization is required in such kind of problems. Okay, so how we are going to store the stack? Okay, so here we'll show the stack. We'll take different sketch pen so we will understand. Initially my pointer SP pointer will give the name SP, which is at -1 position. What is meaning of this one? -1 means initially, after, means if I am getting this -1, means I am reaching to main source code. Okay, now after this start 200, I got this OPER call. Okay, this is one macro OPER, so whose position is 10 position in MDT, and parameters are ARG1. So we'll store this information 10 at 10 position 01, 10 position, and these are the ALA. So which are ALA? ARG1, ARG2. So this ARG1 and ARG2, we are going to replace it with actual parameter AREG and BREG. So here we'll store this AREG and BREG. So this is a ALA of OPER. So in this stack only we are going to store the information of this ALA. Okay, so after 10 I am moving to 11 position. Okay, so here we will increment this 10 to 11. Okay, now at 11 position there is a INCR. INCR means this is a macro call, So we'll get that position from INCR, from MNT we'll get the position 01. Means we have to move to INCR at which position? 01 position. And this INCR hash 1, hash 1 is nothing but this hash 1, which is a AREG. So INCR means we will pass this INCR hash 1 is AREG. Okay. So we have to store that information into stack. At which position we are moving to? 1 position and macro name is INCR. Okay. And the parameter we have passed, that is a AREG, which is a actual parameter. Okay, so we'll write in this way. Now this is a ALA for INCR. Are you getting? Okay, now one position I am here. Now increment it to, we are going to increment it with 2. Now at 2 position, instruction is load 1 hash 1, which is not a macro call. So we'll expand it here. So we'll write this load 1 hash 1. Now hash 1 is current macro, which is a hash 1 position is AREG. So we'll write this AREG here. Now 003 add 1 hash 1. So we are incrementing this counter. Huh? So after this 03 hash 1 is AREG. Now increment it with 4. Okay, so 4 is nothing but MN. So we are going to pop everything. So we are going to pop everything and we'll come back to position, which is a 11 position. Okay, we'll come back to 11. Now I am cutting this one. Okay, because this is popped out. Now we'll come back to 11 position. This INCR is executed. Now increment it to 12. Now at 12 position, there is a one macro call, that is a DECR. Okay, DECR, which whose MDTC is 05. So DECR definition is here. So again 05. So we will push this macro, new macro, whose position is 05 into this tag, and formal parameter is, instead of that num, we are going to pass this, which will hash 2. Hash 2 is nothing but this BREG. Again we come back here. No? So this hash 2 is nothing but BREG. So this is my ALA for DECR. Okay. DECR ALA. Now at 5 position. We now increment it with 6. Okay. 6. So load 2 hash 1. Hash 1 is BREG, current macro. Next statement is sub 2 F 1. Then increment it at 6, after then 7, after then 8. Now at 8 we are store 2 hash 1 is nothing but BREG. Now increment it with 9 and then finally amend. Means that means this macro is also over. Now again we are going to back. Okay, we are going to back. At which position? So again I am going to cut it down. Okay, means we are going to come to the next position. After 12 there is a, after 10, 12 is done. Now 13. At 13 there is a add, which is not a macro call. So add hash 1. Hash 1 is nothing but AREG, current macro. So AREG X, and finally amend. So we will come back after crossing this one, we will get this minus 1 position. This minus 1 position is nothing but come to the next line of source program. Means this is a output, this is a, sorry, up to this one, this is a expansion of this OPER. Okay. Now next is a load X. So load X will write as it is, no macro call is. Then XDS, which is XDC, which is not a macro call. And finally end. So this is my final output. So this is my final output of the programmer. This is a target code. Okay. This is a target code. This is a stack organization. Then this is a MNT. Then MDT and these are the LA. So in exam, such kind of questions are used to ask, show stack organization. These stacks are used in macro call, within macro definition type of problems.
Thank you. If you like this video, click on like button and do not forget to subscribe the channel. Click on bell button to get notification of new videos. Thank you.